So this is Mark, the new owner, and you brought the boat down from Maine a few weeks ago. And so what are your plans?
Well, what I think is about halfway through maybe a 3 or 4 year plan to get myself and also a boat ready for some serious offshore voyaging.
The owner of this 1980 Cape Dory 36 cutter brought his newly purchased boat to me with the goal of working alongside me to do an extensive refit and modifications for liveaboard use and offshore passage making. He's inclined towards sailing with minimal motoring. He does not want to inhabit the boat alongside an inboard diesel. He prefers tiller steering over a wheel as it has now. Wants an outboard well in the aft end of the cockpit with option for electric propulsion or gas outboard if he later decides he needs more range than an electric propulsion battery bank can provide. And he wants to improve the existing sail handling and ground tackle setup, replace the plumbing and electrics, and install self-steering and simplify the boat wherever possible. Coming from an office work background with some sailing experience, he has a serious challenge ahead to learn how to use all the tools and techniques for refitting a boat. At the end, he hopes to have the boat as he envisions it and be competent to sail her on an Atlantic Circle cruise and be able to repair anything on the boat going forward. You can follow along on this video series to see the transformation as it takes place.
Couldn't see anything.
So you've got wheel steering. The wheels stowed somewhere.
The wheels in the bow.
And you said you're interested to convert to tiller steering.
Yes.
Yeah, because it's going to be easier to set up your wind vane self-steering. And under this access plate will be the rudder shaft, I assume. And we'll have to make some adapter fittings to get a tiller on there.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And that's where, I guess, the emergency tiller that the boat probably has would fit.
Right. That's the emergency tiller right down there. Okay.
Right. So if we're going to build a outboard well back here for an electric outboard, we're going to have to bring this forward as far as possible. Mm-hmm. Maybe to here or a little further, and rebuild the aft end of the cockpit here. Mm-hmm. So we'll get measurements on that soon.
Okay.
Up here you've got mid-boom sheeting, a traveler over the forward end of the hatch here. Got the distinctive Cape Dory bronze opening port lights. Five on each side for the 36 footer.
We've got some fuel in here.
Okay, there's a huge diesel tank. Stands up pretty high too.
Yeah, and this is the deck plate for the diesel.
Yeah, the diesel fill over on this side. You've got a smaller cockpit. Locker lid here, full of batteries and some other stuff. That's because you've got a quarter berth on this side.
Yes.
That's why this locker is so short. So here's the quarter berth and a nav table. Switch panel under the companionway and the galley. This boat has a Rego 6000 combination two-burner stove with oven. That's kind of nice. You don't have to deal with propane issues.
Yep.
And explosion threat.
Yep.
Nice big sink there. We've got two bunks here in the salon. And the headroom up here is about 6'2" aft.
Yeah.
And I think it comes up a little bit here, probably about 6'3" here. And then it starts to taper down slightly forward. There's the toilet. Looks like you've got an electric toilet.
Yes.
You might be converting to composting toilet for simplicity, or a lavac?
I would definitely, it's got to be manual one way or another, and compost toilet is definitely an option I'd like to think about.
Yeah.
The idea of not having a tank buried in inside the boat somewhere with waste is very appealing.
Sure. And the V-berth, it's got a insert cushion here, chain locker forward. She's in pretty good shape, isn't she, overall?
Yeah.
We had the crane come and hoist the mast yesterday, and we guided it down through the deck onto the step on the keel. It's got some Stay-Lock hardware on the rigging. It's got the staysail stay here set up so that it's removable with this quick release pin at the bottom and these fold out handles for the turnbuckle. That can be moved aft if you're not going to be using a staysail or a storm jib and you want to have easier tacking of the jib. After doing some test sails, the owner decided he doesn't want to keep the staysail boom. He wants to use the staysail loose-footed. So we're going to remove that and the hardware and add some new sheet blocks in the right location. Now that means he'll have to tack the thing manually instead of the self-tacking staysail boom there, but that has kind of limited usefulness, and it blocks dinghy stowing and clutters up the foredeck. The 6.5 foot pram dinghy fits pretty well over the forward hatch on the coach roof. We're ready to begin the electric outboard motor conversion since we determined that the shape of the overhanging hull and transom and a large lazarette locker are suitable.